some breaking developments coming in from India right before we go to that story. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has constituted the Economic Advisory Council to address issues of macro importance in the country. This will be headed by Bibek Debroy. Joining us for more on this is WION's political editor, Karthike Sharma. What more do we know about this key economic body, Karthike?
You see, you know, this has to be seen in context of the economy, which is not doing very well. So there are two important things which are happening simultaneously. One, as we broke in our last bulletin, that the Prime Minister is going to announce a scheme in next 15 minutes where he intends to electrify every village in this country. Now, the second announcement has come. You see, the government is not using the word stimulus, or government is not using the word intervention. But the, if you analyze the announcements being made by the Prime Minister's office, major changes are taking place in India. Now, because you have an economic ministry in charge of the finance, what Prime Minister has done is to create a separate body which is called Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister. This Economic Advisory Council is not going to report to the Finance Minister. This will be directly reporting to the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. An important thing in this is that you have independent economists, not the bureaucrats. You have people from other economic ecosystem reporting to the Prime Minister. Bibek Debroy, who's known for his fierce and independent opinion, will be reporting to the Prime Minister as head of this body. He will be, then the opinion will be coming from Surjit Bhalla, Ratim Roy, Ashima Goyal, Ratan Vattal, you know, and Ratan Vattal is principal advisor, Niti Aayog. So these are important people. And look at the word, because ultimately in Indian context, the wording of the reference makes a difference. They will analyze any issue, economic or otherwise, referred to it by Prime Minister and advising the Prime Minister thereon. Addressing issues of macroeconomic importance and presenting views thereon to the Prime Minister, this could either be suo motu or reference from the Prime Minister, of which the Prime Minister can tell them to do it. And lastly, attending to any other task as may be desired by the Prime Minister. So in context of the slowdown, the current deficit which India faces, post, I would say, demonetization and the problem which accrues because of GST, and it has happened in many countries, these are actions which the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, is taking. So I think more than anything, the very composition represents a thinking within the government that certain fresh thoughts and intervention in terms of policy is required by the government.
Given specifically the economic scenario, as you pointed out, Karthike, but also the choice of Bibek Debroy is not a surprising one. Of course, indications have been coming in to this effect for quite some time now.
Absolutely. If you remember, Bibek Debroy was a fiercest critic of Sonia Gandhi. You know, he was appointed, during the Congress time in terms, and there were references in terms of certain positions or on economy. But Mr. Debroy had taken a very different position. But leaving that aside, in terms of whether he had differences with then incumbent regime or not, he is an intellectual mind in his own mind, and Prime Minister, thereby seeing that certain trends, certain developments, certain narrative is defining the Indian economy, is trying to take these steps. That is why the word corrective or stimulus is not used. You have an Economic Advisory Council directly reporting to the Prime Minister. 15 minutes down the line, the Indian Prime Minister is going to announce the most ambitious scheme ever launched in past 20 years. That is to tell the country, that is to tell India, that every village is going to get electrified. You know, you can't get more ambitious than this, but nonetheless, that's what the announcement is going to be.
Absolutely. That will, of course, take place in just a short while from now, as we broke that news just a short while back. But Karthike, speaking a little bit more about the role that Bibek Debroy will actually be playing in terms of, he has a huge challenge up ahead, given the current economic scenario which is emerging within the country, also given the GDP dip. We're looking at a situation which, of course, needs to be tackled as soon as possible. The opposition, of course, has been going all guns blazing against the government, specifically over the issue, also the issue of demonetization, which, has attracted harsh criticism from all quarters.
See, India is a network economy. It's not only internal demonetization or, for example, as you mentioned, the GST. It's also global. For example, last week, the market crashed because the way Trump tweeted and the way the statement came from the North Korean government, the markets didn't do well. You know, in 2008, we were able to buffer ourselves when the Lehman Brothers completely collapsed. But today is a different world. We are far more exposed. Indian banking system has large NPAs. That is the inheritance of the BJP from UPA. So the, not only the banks are exposed, they also need more liquidity, more money is required in infrastructure. But these are nitty-gritties of the finance, which I don't want to get into, because the larger push here is that the job employment, the infrastructure and certain other segments are slowing down. That is why you see a slight shrinkage in the shrinkage in our growth rate, and the CAD, which is current account deficit, it has risen. It needs to be immediately plugged in, or else economy becomes a problem. My understanding is the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi understands the importance of the movement where he stands. 1.5 years, he led Lok Sabha elections, and he wants to have economy under control.